In our code, we're going to initialize the adapter within the placeholder fragment on createView method, because that's where we want the list view to be populated with data. We're using an array adapter, and we can initialize it with four parameters: a context, the ID of a list item layout, the ID of a text view within that list item layout, as well as the list of data. We'll go through each of these parameters one by one now. First, for context, it contains global information about the app environment. It allows us to access system services and resources, as well as the application-specific resources that we've defined. We use the fragments containing activity as a context, so we're going to call getActivity for our parameter here. Since the adapter needs to know the layout for each list item, it needs some reference to the XML layouts that we've defined. The r.java class is a generated file that creates human-readable identifiers for our resources. For the list item layout, we refer to it in code as r.layout.listItemForecast. This was the name of the XML file that we created earlier. Next, the array adapter needs to know how to take the weather forecast string and set that to be displayed in a text view. So we pass in the ID of the text view that we defined earlier in the list item layout. Even though these two resource IDs look similar, one starts with r.layout while the other starts with r.id. r.layout refers to a layout file, while an ID refers to a specific XML element with the matching ID attribute. And lastly, we pass in week forecast, which is the array list of forecast data that we defined earlier. Now go ahead and initialize your adapter. Check this box when you're done.